ladies and gentlemen. That was, of course, the Darktown Sutter's Ball, more or less in the style of the original Dixieland Jazz Band. And Klaus has asked me to do some speaking. He says he's all talked out. I think he might have used up his English vocabulary.
I don't understand.
But that's all right, the audience doesn't either. We're going to play some wonderful tunes from this great band, one of the first, if not the first, jazz band, depending on who you talk to. And we're going to move along now with one of their really big hits. This was originally called Barnyard Blues. I think it was then renamed Livery Stable Blues, and one of their really famous ones. It has some novelty effects, and we hope you enjoy them.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I found some new words in English. Fantastic. Of course, I could not play with this lovely band because there was no alto saxophone on this particular recording. So I'm sorry to set aside, but it was lovely. And I want to introduce, of course, Mr. Larry Shields in the form of today, which is wonderful. Michael McQuaid as a clarinet soloist on this clarinet. Andy Shum as Mr. La Roca. Jim Fryer struggling with lovely parts I've written. But it's fantastic trombone playing. You know, these guys were very clever. They did announcement like, we searched for a trombone player who couldn't read. And couldn't understand music, and we are absolutely out of. We found the right person, Jim Fry. Of course, this was bullshit. As that's another word I just remembered.
That's a good one. I think that's an Australian word, actually.
On drums, we have the lovely Nick Ward. He has to do all the rhythm work and work like a devil, doesn't he? Wonderful. And on piano, as Mr. Ragaz himself, we have Morten Gunnarsson.
And of course, Klaus Jacobi on the alto sax occasionally, and also these very fine arrangements. Thank you, Klaus. Here's one called the Jasmine Blues. Thank you. my first visit to the US, I've been there twice. My first visit to the US, I was lucky enough to go to New York City, where I was touring with Andy, actually, Andy and Josh, and some other Australians. And we went and heard Jim Fryer with Vince Giordano's Nighthawks and did all sorts of fun things. But when we were playing our gig, we were just near the original site of Rice and Weber's restaurant, which is where all of this music really kicked off with the original Dixieland Jazz Band. It was their hit venue, if you like. And it's now, is it a 7-Eleven? I think it's a 7-Eleven. Yeah, we went into this 7-Eleven on the corner. It's kind of very kind of crudely lit and full of people who are just buying some overpriced groceries. And we sort of stood in there. I think we may even have played an ODJB record on our phones and sort of stood there and felt weird. And we felt even more weird when we saw the looks that everyone was giving us. Anyway, so we're going to move along now. This is one called Margie. Of course, it's the Margie you know and love. But as with many of the ODJB's later songs, it incorporated another melody. And I think this might have been the first recording even of Russell Robertson's Singin' the Blues. Thank you. suppose one of the things about the original Dixieland Jazz Band was how much energy they had, and all these novelty effects like you heard before with the instruments imitating the sounds of animals and all sorts of other things. The drummer played a kazoo, and you know, they had all sorts of tricks and costumes and fun things to keep an audience entertained, unlike us. One of their tricks, though, was to perform some Oriental foxtrots. It was a big craze in the early 20s. This one is actually from 1920, to play songs that evoked the Orient, or at least the ideas that they had in countries like America and England about what the Orient was like. Here's one called Palestina, which has a little bit of that feel. Tune, but please thank the members of the band with us. We've got Jim Fryer, Andy Shum, Nick Ward, Ross Jacoby, Morgan Gamalasa, and my name is Michael Ford. This one has a novelty effect too. I'll leave it up to your imagination. It's called Bow Wow Blues.
My mama treats me like a dog.